Most Christians are not aware of the importance of praying in the morning. The practice of praying in the morning should begin when you first wake up before work or school and give everything you have to the Lord. I know the challenges most of us go through every day. Most of us have a busy life, getting the kids ready for school, getting yourself ready for work, the constant traffic you have to deal with. This is the reason why it's important for you to pray in the morning, because early morning prayer can help you defeat temptation, defeat the devil, make you strong for whatever you encounter during your day. There are many reasons to pray in the morning. Our Lord Jesus Christ prayed in the morning. Mark 1 verse 35 to 37 tells us, "Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went off to a solitary place where he prayed. Simon and his companions went to look for him, and when they found him, they exclaimed, 'Everyone is looking for you.'" Another reason to pray in the morning is to give praise and thanks to God for protecting us while we were sleeping. It is one of the highest forms of worship we can offer. Psalm 63 verse 1 tells us, "You God are my God. Earnestly I seek you. I thirst for you. My whole being longs for you in a dry and parched land where there is no water." Many of the greatest people in the Bible start their mornings with prayer. The importance of starting your day with prayer cannot be overstated. In the book of Daniel, Daniel prays three times a day. Daniel 6 verse 10 tells us, "Now when Daniel learned that the decree has been published, he went home to his upstairs room where the windows opened towards Jerusalem. Three times a day he got down on his knees and prayed, giving thanks to his God, just as he had done before." In the book of Job, Job always starts his morning with a powerful early morning prayer. In Job's 1 verse 4 to 5, his sons used to hold feasts in their homes on their birthdays, and they will invite their three sisters to eat and drink with them. When a period of feasting had run its course, Job will make arrangement for them to be purified. Early in the morning, he will sacrifice a burnt offering for each of them, thinking, "Perhaps my children have sinned and cursed God in their hearts." This was Job's regular custom. Abraham also prayed in the morning. In Genesis 22 verse 3, early the next morning, Abraham got up and loaded his donkey. He took with him two of his servants and his son Isaac. When he had cut enough wood for the burnt offering, he set out for the place God had told him about. Joshua always prayed in the morning. Joshua 6 verse 12 to 13. Joshua got up early the next morning, and the priests took up the ark of the Lord. The seven priests carrying the seven trumpets went forward, marching before the ark of the Lord and blowing the trumpets. The armed men went ahead of them, and the rear guard followed the ark of the Lord while the trumpet kept sounding. Moses always started his morning with powerful early morning prayer also. In Exodus 34 verse 1 to 5, the Lord says to Moses, "Chisel out two tablets like the first one, and I will write on them the words that were on the first tablets which you broke. Be ready in the morning, and then come up to Mount Sinai. Present yourself to me there on the top of the mountain. No one is to come with you or seen anywhere on the mountain. Not even the flocks or herds may graze in front of the mountain." So Moses chiseled out two stone tablets like the first one and went up Mount Sinai early in the morning as the Lord had commanded him. And he carried the two stone tablets in his hands. Then the Lord came down in a cloud and stood there with him and proclaimed his name, the Lord. Jacob also prayed in the morning. In Genesis 28 verse 18 to 19, early the next morning, Jacob took the stone he had placed under his head and set it up as a pillar and put oil on top of it. He called that place Bethel, though the city used to be called Luz. Praying first thing in the morning is a great time to communicate with God. Psalm 5 verse 3 says, "In the morning, Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning, I lay my request before you and wait expectantly." When you pray in the morning, you are prepared for any demonic attack during the day. Keep in mind, all great progress comes with sacrifice. If you're having a challenging time praying in the morning, I encourage you to find time to pray. Commit to God the first hour of your day by praying. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I pray this prayer in the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bind and I rebuke and bring to no effect all division, all discord, all disunity, all strife, wrath, any murder, criticism, condemnation, any pride, any envy and jealousy, any gossip and slander, evil speaking, complaining, lying, false teaching, false gifts, false manifestation, any lying signs and wonders, poverty, any fear of lack, fear of spirits, deceiving spirits, religious spirits, hindering spirits. Father, I bring revenge spirit, occult spirit, witchcraft spirits, including Jezebel, Delilah, and any Apollyon, the destroyer spirits of Antichrist, and all familiar and territorial spirits. I bind all curses that have been spoken against me. I bless those who curse me, and pray blessings on those who despitefully use me. I bind all spoken judgment made against me, and judgments I made against others. I bind the power of negative words from others, and I bind and render useless all prayers not inspired by the Holy Spirit, whether psychic, soul force, witchcraft, or counterfeit tongues that have been prayed against me. I am God's child. I resist the devil. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. I put on the whole armor of God. I take authority over this day in Jesus' name. Let it be prosperous for me, and let me walk in your love, Lord. The Holy Spirit leads and guides me today and fills me with all needed gifting and grace. I discern between the righteous and the wicked. I take authority over Satan and all his demons and those people who are influenced by them. I declare Satan is under my feet and shall remain there all day. I am the righteous of God in Christ Jesus. I am God's property. Satan, you are bound for my family, for my mind, my body, my home, and my finances. I confess that I am healed and whole, am long-lived, stable, durable, incorruptible, fruitful, virtuous, full of peace and patience and love. Whatsoever I set my hands to do shall prosper, for God supplies all my needs. I have authority over Satan, all his demons, and beasts of the field. God, I pray for the ministry you have for me. Anoint me, God, for all you have called me to do. I call for divine appointments, open doors of opportunity, God-ordained encounters, and ministry positions. I claim an edge of protection by the precious blood of Jesus around myself, my spouse, my children, throughout this day. I ask you, God, in the name of Jesus, to dispatch angels to surround me, my spouse, and my children, today and every day, and put them through my house and around our cars, our souls, and body. I call on your holy angels to protect my house from any intrusion and to protect me and my family from any harmful demonic or other physical or mental attacks. I ask all this in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord. He has been my Savior. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I declare your Lordship over this day. I get under your covering and anointing of the early riser. I command the morning to take hold at the end of the earth and shake the wicked out of it. I will have dominion over the devil in the morning. Lord, make the outgoing of the morning to rejoice. I receive your loving kindness every morning. Release the beauty of your holiness from the womb of the morning. Let your light break forth in my life as the morning. Let your judgment come upon the enemy morning by morning. Lord, your going forth is prepared as the morning, and we pray that you will come as the rain, the latter and the former rain upon the earth. Lord, you visit me every morning. Lord, you awaken me morning by morning. You awake my ear to hear. I will not be afraid of the arrow that flies by day or the terror that comes at night. Lord, show forth your salvation in my life from day to day. Lord, release mystery to me to bring heaven down to earth. I come to agreement with the heavens to declare your glory. The chief angels with their flaming swords are battling on my behalf ahead of time. My appointed time has been declared by God in heaven. At sunrise, the dawns will give birth to the will of God, and light will shine upon the wickedness to shake it from the heavens. At twilight, my enemy shall flee, and newly found spoils would await me at my destination. My destiny is inevitable. O God, let my prayers reach you this morning. I command the morning, its ears to open to me and hear my cry. Let conception take place that Holy Spirit prayers will reign and be dispatched upon the earth and do your will. I come in the earth to get placed to receive heavenly instructions on my behalf. I come in all the elements of creation to heed and obey. As my praise resounds and the day breaks, the earth shall yield increase unto me. I declare the first light has come. The first fruits of my morning is holy, and the entire day is holy. I prophesy the will of God to the morning, so the day spring dawn will know its place in my day. I declare that the first light will shake the wickedness from the four corners of the earth. The lines, my portions are falling on my behalf in pleasant, sweet, agreeable places, and I have a secure heritage. I am strategically lined up with the ladder and touches the third heaven and sits on the earth. The angels are descending and ascending according to the words I speak. Whatever is bound or loose on earth is already bound or loose in heaven. Revelation, healing, deliverance, salvation, peace, joy, relationships, finances, promotions, and resources that have been demonically blocked are being loosed unto me today. I am contagiously blessed. As I come in the morning and capture the day, time is being redeemed. The people of God has taken authority over the fourth watch of the day. The spiritual airways and highways are being hijacked by Jesus. The atmospheres of the airways over me, my family, my church, my workplace, my ministry, my neighborhood, my city and nation, and the world are producing new climate. This new climate is constructing a godly stronghold in times of trouble. The thinking of people will be conducive to the agenda of the kingdom of heaven. Every demonic agenda, evil thought pattern designed against the agenda of the kingdom of heaven is destroyed at the root of conception in Jesus' name. I come into agreement with the saints as we suffer violence. The violent take it by force. No longer will we accept just anything and everything that is dealt to us in our days. We declare that the kingdom of God has come and the will of God be done on earth as it is in heaven. As the sun rises, let it shine favorably upon the people of God. Daily, destiny is my portion because I have no thought for tomorrow. I am riding on the wings of the morning in a new day of victory. God, you separate the night and day. The Lord has given me dominion over all the elements of the works of his hand. He has placed them under my feet. I fear the name of the Lord. The Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in his wings, and I shall thread down the wicked until they become ashes under my feet. I decree and declare a new day, a new season, and a fresh anointing. The ingredients of my destiny are programmed into my days, my years, and seasons. I bound every evil force that will try to capture my destiny in Jesus' name. I plead the blood of Jesus over every principality, every power and rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places, a sign against the purpose of God for my life, my family. I bind every destiny thief. I bind every destiny pirate and destiny devourer in the name of Jesus. They are dethroned and dismantled in Jesus' name. I declare they have no influence over my days. Every curse sent, my day is bound, broken, and rendered powerless and sent to the cross. I displace the Luciferian spirit. I bind every false light bearer in Jesus' name. My prayers will disrupt dark plains and give my enemies a non-prosperous day. I have victory over my enemies every morning. My day will prosper. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be exceedingly glad in it. The Lord Jesus Christ indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord. He has been my Savior. To God be all the glory today. In Jesus' name, amen.